Here on Lake Gaston, the day before the BFL. Got a couple of spots marked that I found on the on Google Maps. So I'm gonna run through those today, see if I can get some bites. Weather's gonna be up to about 90 today and gonna be in the 90s tomorrow. So really, really gonna be hot for April. Maybe we'll get some bites today, figure some stuff out and use it for tomorrow. We'll see. So just as a little midday update, I've had a few bites, you know, here and there scattered around, and sort of doing a lot of marking and not a lot of fishing. I marked two good ones on a bed, so sort of looking around trying to find some more. Don't really want to have one bed. If there's fish on beds, you want to have as many as you possibly can. And then I'm just flipping some grass, getting bit doing that, and then sort of hitting some bluff walls with a shaky head to try and catch some spots. Lost one and getting some bites, but yeah, that's kind of the deal so far. Hopefully we can catch, get some more bites and figure some more of this out. Really weird, so there's a lot of water being pushed into this lake, so it's been raining really hard around here. Carr Lake, the lake that's connected to this and just separated by the dam, is up I think almost 7 feet, so they're dumping a lot of that water into Gaston, and it's sort of dirtying up the water. So I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I've been fishing near the dam, so that water is pretty clean. And now I'm going to try and fish some of this more, stained water closer to Carr Lake. So, we'll see if this, if anything changes or if it's easier or more difficult to get bites. All right. Thank you. All right. So it is tournament morning. It's 3:15 in the morning, and I'm on the road to Lake Gaston. It's about an hour and a half drive from my house. I'm not too confident about my game plan or the fish I found. It's going to be a grind, I know that much. And, hopefully I can just stick it out and get 5 fish in the boat, you know. I found some bedding fish yesterday, and about maybe 3 sets of beds with males and females on them. But I'm boat 108, so hopefully other people haven't found them either, and I can get on them and catch those pretty quick. It's a little overcast this morning, so that might be a little difficult. Yeah, we just gotta, first things first, you just gotta get that first fish in the boat and then see how the day goes. But I'm excited and ready to go.
Keeper. Knew he's gonna come off.
Number one, finally.
Sir, buddy. Let's go. I think we got something, buddy. That was a fun fight too, huh? He went straight down that grass line.
Alright, so it is the day after the BFL on Lake Gaston. Really tough tournament. And I only had two fish. I only weighed two fish. And I was really just disappointed, really bummed out, you know. And I was just sort of worn out with the last, you know, few hours of the tournament. Just did not make good decisions. Didn't make good decisions the whole tournament, to be honest with you. I was just running around like a chicken with my head cut off, like I did the last tournament, which I told myself I didn't want to do. And it cost me. I mean, I only weighed two fish. The two fish I caught went back to back within like 10 minutes, right when I pulled up in the area. So I was like, you know, after that happened, I was like, oh, I'm going to stick it out here the rest of the day. You know, hour and a half goes by without a bite, and I start just trying to force stuff into happening. And it was just the type of day where I just needed to just stick it out, you know, have confidence in the area, and then just try and hope, you know, to get some more bites. But instead, I went running up and down the lake, and, you know, with about 2 hours to go, I was almost out of gas in my boat, which is pretty ridiculous. So despite only having two fish for 5 pounds, 5 ounces, I still managed to beat most of the field. So it was a tough day for everybody. I think I finished 83rd out of 167 boats. So a lot of people just didn't catch anything. A lot of people weighed, you know, one fish. So despite only having 5 pounds, I moved up in points, surprisingly. So I went from 42nd in points to 39. So now I'm inside the top 40. Top 40 go to the regional. And that's the goal. You want to make the regional. It's basically, it gives you an opportunity to you know, make it to the next level. So, all in all, I mean, disappointed with the fishing overall, but not disappointed with the finish too much, or and the fact that I moved up in points. So, you know, to have a bad day and, you know, still move up in points is good in that, you know, I learned a lot. I learned about, you know, what not to do and things not to do, but didn't cost me too much in points. So I have another BFL next weekend in the Shenandoah Division on the Potomac River. We're launching in Maryland, so it's going to be a bit of a drive for me. And it's a place I've never fished before. I really like fishing the James River, but who knows, man? We'll see. I have really nothing to go off of, so I'm only going to have one day of practice, so going to try and keep it as simple as I possibly can. Fish just a couple of creeks and just figure out how to catch fish in those areas. And all right, I will see you then, and hopefully we can, you know, right the ship a little bit, have a good finish there.
I went out walking towards the sun, a free man of conscience with my gun, a free